All tourism destinations are climate sensitive to a point. As humans, our attention is mostly drawn to what catches the eye, meaning if it's pretty, we'll find the urge to go there. This is where my advocacy plays a role. Join me as I take you through my beautiful country.
South Africa has 11 official languages: Afrikaans, Tswana, Tonga, Zulu, Ndebele, Sotho, Xhosa, English, Pedi, Venda, and Siswati. We also have 9 provinces: Gauteng, which is the province with the union buildings; Eastern Cape, the province of the rising sun, Mpumalanga; Northern Cape, Western Cape, Limpopo; Northwest, Free State; and last but not least, KwaZulu-Natal, found on the east coast of South Africa. This is why South Africa is called the Rainbow Nation. KwaZulu-Natal is one of our most diverse provinces in all aspects, such as our cuisines, with a variety of culinary traditions embodied by various communities that inhabit our province. For instance, braais, where guests, could be friends or family, get together for a hangout and eat grilled meat. This could last for hours. But there are certain rules as well as etiquette. The most important part is the fire, wood and charcoal. We also have toffee apples, or caramelized apple, on a steak, and spiced pineapple, all found along our shores, and a personal favorite, rickshaw rides. We also have several tribal groups. I am a descendant of the Sotho and Ndebele tribes. What's special about the tribes are the different initiation processes one goes through at each phase. For example, women have umemulo, and when a woman gets married, there's a bride price that's received by the bride's family, as well as cows. They are all important traditions. In Durban, you can find several tourist attractions, like the Moses Mabhida Stadium, which was built for the 2010 World Cup. This is a venue for several events, such as bungee jumping, sports, and international concerts, having hosted Chris Brown, Nicki Minaj, and many more. Another significantly historic attraction is here where I stand today, Ohlange Institute, founded by John Langalibalele Dube, former president of what is now known as the ANC. But not only that, former president, anti-apartheid revolutionary and philanthropist Nelson Mandela casted his first vote in 1994 here, where he went on to be the president and South Africa was free. I am Dumi Gianni, a 15-year-old representing my country, South Africa, the Rainbow Nation. I am an entrepreneur owning an online luxury sleepwear company called TJ Luxury Sleepwear. During my spare time, I enjoy reading books, taking a walk by the beach, and traveling the world with my family. To keep myself fit and motivated, I play tennis, hockey, and netball. My hobbies are art, violin, and voice. I strongly advocate for global warming and climate change, as I believe that through education, the sky is the limit.
We've been done long before it all began. Still can't give it up. Lead me on, but leave before the morning comes. Even though it's what we want, can't keep this up for long. But I just don't wanna leave you. Might just throw away the reasons why we both can't lay.
drawing down on my mother. She knows I'm safe with you, and she stands under my colors always. Life ain't always what you think it ought to be, no. Ain't even gray, but she buries her baby. The sharp knife of a shoreline. Oh, well, I've had just enough time. Whoa. Lay me down on a bed of roses, take me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song.
As a young entrepreneur, I run my brand TJ Luxury Sleepwear. It has been quite a challenge shipping my products to clients out of South Africa. So without flights, which I believe are part of tourism, it is almost impossible to run a business smoothly. From a person as a cleaner at a fancy restaurant or hotel, to a master chef at a five-star hotel, or even a hotel manager, these people all rely on tourism to keep them going. So I believe that tourism does create job opportunities. As we all know, tourism is the gateway of several services, from food importance to holiday destinations. So I believe that tourism most definitely does create job opportunities, having witnessed the damages of the COVID-19 pandemic and countries being closed down and everything being on standstill. Having mentioned a hotel, which is one of the common places in which people stay when on a business trip or vacation, especially at these times when we are all trying to restore or get back to the similar, if not same, lifestyle as prior.